This week's podcast is a quick and easy one, and in my opinion, a fun one as well. During the past few lectures, we have been talking about the four American idioms, but why, you may ask? Well, in 1892, Czechoslovakian composer Antonín Dvořák was invited to head the National Conservatory in New York at an exorbitant salary of $15,000 a year. The salary was paid by a wealthy philanthropist named Jeanette Thurber, who had also founded the National Conservatory. Dvořák's works in Europe had reflected the musical idioms of his country. Specifically, he had used Czechoslovakian folk music in his compositions. When he arrived in New York, he was determined to help codify a truly American form of fine art music. And how would he do this? In the same way he had done back at home, by integrating America's national idioms into the compositions. And composers did just that. Now, take this bit of information and combine it with the fact that the operettas being produced at this time were also using national idioms. Strauss was using those Viennese waltzes to set the mood for his shows, and Gilbert and Sullivan utilized idioms from outside England in their pastiche of various styles. It was only natural that American musical theater composers would go in the same direction, and they did. Your assignment this week is to identify four different songs from Broadway shows that utilize one of each of the four idioms: African-American plantation music, hymns, parlor songs, and folk songs. And just to get you started, I've given you examples of my own. One of my favorite derivations of the spiritual is gospel music. Notice how Alan Menken juxtaposes the spiritual, or gospel song, with this epic Greek tale in A Star is Born from Hercules. He's a hero who can please the crowd. A star is born. Come on, everybody, shout out loud. A star is born. Just remember, let the cosmos go. Within your heart, the power
make it true. You'll get the power when you're born.
That's Bill's point.
Keep your eyes on the prize.
Adam Gettle, who is famous now for his Light in the Piazza, also used the juxtaposition of Greek mythology and American sacred music when he mixed the two in his first stage work, Myths and Hymns. See if you can notice the hymn-like melody, harmony, and lyric in At the Sounding, despite the multi-metered and odd accompaniment.
At the sound of the trumpet, when the saints are gathered home, we will greet each other by the
Gettle used several of the idioms in his magnificent Floyd Collins. Listen to his use of folk ballad in The Ballad of Floyd Collins.
Deep in the land of the hollows and creeks, if and you get lost, you get lost for weeks. Listen to the tale of a man who got lost 100 feet under the winter frost. Now Floyd was a reasoning man. He knew what he wanted and he had a plan. He was just as smart as he was brave. He was gonna find him the perfect cave. Even Floyd knew something wasn't right. He was suffering nightmares at night. But he didn't worry about what he dreamed. Things was going good, or so it seemed. Went looking for his fortune under the ground.
Sure enough, his fortune is what he found.
And finally, one of my favorite musicals of the Golden Age is Meredith Willson's The Music Man. Listen to his pastiche on the parlor song in Good Night, My Someone.
Thank you.
accompaniment, melodic line, and lyric to Stephen Foster's Beautiful Dreamer. Notice how both have a waltz-like feel to them.
Beautiful dreamer, wake unto me. Starlight and dewdrops are waiting for thee. Sounds of the rude world heard in the day, lulled by the moonlight, have all passed away. Beautiful dreamer, queen of my song, list while I woo.